I'm so happy to see you. Do you want to chat with me? Great. I've got so much to tell you. You are so daring climbing up here. But I mean it. This is such a great way to meet you. Are you on your own? So how come I just saw Ginger? Fine. It's not very romantic with Ginger around. Why do you encourage him? Ginger is cute, but not while you're being romantic. Then he's a pest. Stop him. I thought we were going to have a romantic chat up here. You bring out the best in me, singing. Wanna sing with me? Cool, let's start.
You get me, and I get you.
Together, there's really nothing we can do.
I got your back,
and I've got yours too.
Yeah, you get me, and I'm pretty sure that I get you.
You are so handsome. Think nothing of it. I thought I saw some flowers. Is this a special occasion? You are such a romantic. My pleasure. Are you going to give me flowers? They're gorgeous. Right. Who do you love? I'm jealous. Have you thought about kissing me? It's a start. How much do you love me? That much? Will you hold my paw? Your fur is so soft. You make me tingle. Shall I kiss you? Great. Is this true love? I think so too. Are you my Romeo? I am your Juliet. Do you have a gift for me? It's a lovely ring. Yes, do you remember when you first saw me? You said I was beautiful. I remember you walking down an alleyway between two big dingy dark warehouses. I was with my friends and we were lost. You saved us. Remember our first date? For our first date you took me for a walk along the waterfront and we had fish tacos. Do you remember when you took my paw in yours? It sent shivers right down to the tip of my tail. Shall I kiss you again? What did you think about me at first? You said I was the most beautiful cat you'd ever seen. I thought you were so cool and knew everybody. You were in charge. Okay. When I met you, I was with my friends and I suddenly felt shy. I could hardly say a word to you. Did you think I was a dumb kitty? I was just in awe of you. I like to hang out with my friends. We go to the mall or some of our favorite shopping streets. I like having friends over for dress-up parties and for clothes swaps. I style them, it's lots of fun. What do you do with your friends for fun? There are several cafes where I usually hang out and meet up with friends. I have three best female friends. Do you have a lot of close friends? Never mind, the number doesn't mean anything. I don't count friends. I have no idea how many friends I have. I know a lot of people, but I'm not labeling all of them friends. Who is your best friend? I think Tom is my best friend. How long have you been best friends? That's tragic. You need to go find some. I've known most of my friends since I was a kitten. We love to go out all together, but it's hard getting our schedules to mesh. I am so busy. One of my girlfriends is traveling during her gap year. Another started work as an intern and is crazy busy. The third has just started university. I'm envious of those friends who know what they want to do next. Do you like animals? Cool. Let's talk about pets. Do you have any other animal friends besides me? Ass? That's not a common pet. What could you feed it? Do you keep your ass in a cage or do you let it loose? Aren't you afraid of your ass sneaking up on you? A pet ass sneaking up on you isn't as bad as a tiger doing so. You are reduced to guessing? Do you walk your pet ass? Cool. I very much like to compare pets and their owners. Do you feed your ass a healthy diet? As you should. And a shrimp cocktail for me, please. Do you play with your ass? If I had a pet ass, I would too. Did you name your ass after a hero? Okay. Do you dress your pet up? It'd better be stylish or you might end up in a fashion prison. Enjoy. Did your ass go to the pet school? Does your pet ass like the outdoors? I once let my pet hamster loose in the garden. It sent me a postcard from Hamsterdam a week later. I'm not stopping you. Does your ass like children? Nothing better than a kid's pet for a good purr. Does your pet know any tricks? Cool, your ass is obviously a genius. I once thought my hamster could dance, but it just ate all my salad and watched CSI Miami. If you could have any animal as a pet, what would you have? Ass? That's not a common pet. Indeed. Let's play a mini game about pets. Would you have a zebra for a pet? Me too. I would use it as an inspiration for designing pajamas. How about a chameleon for a pet? I hear they're the best at hide and seek. Do you think a lemur could be a pet? So you'd have an excuse to join their daily siestas? How about an elephant for a pet? Would you have one? Right. Where would you even put an elephant? You could put it into the fridge. Fine. Would you ever have a pig as a pet? Pigs are smart. Do you think they could be butlers? You're right. With a pig for a butler, the food would never make it to my plate. What about a bat? Would you share your room with a bat? Would you also be ready to move into a cave together with your pet bat? Yeah, I mean if it would at least give you superpowers. I hear chinchillas are some of the furriest pets. Would you ever own one? Why not? Do you have something against little cute hairballs? I bet you could generate a lot of static electricity by rubbing them with a balloon. Yup. Hey, would you have a penguin as a companion? I think a penguin would make the best model for me to design a tuxedo. Would you ever have an octopus as a pet? I would too. My pen's running low on ink. Roses are red. Violets are blue. I made a love quiz just for you. A. Sweet. B. Let's play. One, love gives us wings. True or false? A, true, B, false. Two, while looking at someone you love, your pupils get smaller. A, true, B, false. Right. Three, when two people in love sit close to each other, their heart rates synchronize. A, true, B, false. Two hearts really do beat as one when you're in love. 4. Long ago, illiterates signed documents with a cross and then kissed it to show their sincerity. That's why X nowadays stands for a kiss. A. True. B. False. And it also looks like crossed lips. Sort of. And a bonus question about those butterflies in the stomach. How do they get in? A. When we stare open-mouthed. B. When we trip head over heels, see, they're always there, ready to flutter. Burp. I agree. Ta-da, we're through. You got 3 out of 5 points. I have a little gift for you, Talking Tom's Cute Love Stories. Click here, http://outfit7.com/cute-love-stories. It was nothing. Are you a movie fan? Great. Let's meow about meowies. What do you like more, watching movies or reading books? Me too. Movies are just great. I have a vivid imagination, but I also love to see what other people imagined. Do you like going to the cinema? A huge screen, excellent sound, a crowd gasping in unison. You can't get that in your living room. How do you feel about people talking in the cinema? If it's a blockbuster action flick, the explosions can drown their chatter out. Just don't talk during a romantic movie. I never miss a romantic comedy. They're my favorite type of movie. Do you like rom-coms? I sometimes get too mushy when watching rom-coms. I get this really stupid grin that Tom makes fun of. Who do you think is the hottest actor right now? Fair enough. Do you watch the Oscars? I know the Oscars celebrate blockbuster movies and not art house films, but I'm a girl who likes her movies flashy. Yes, I don't know what they have in common. Which Oscar-nominated movie did you like the best? Pick one: American Sniper, Birdman, Boyhood, The Grand Budapest Hotel, The Imitation Game, Selma, The Theory of Everything, or Whiplash? It hurts my brain to suppose things. I prefer reality. Do you go see movies on opening weekend? I hate hearing spoilers. The sooner I see the movie, the better. How do you watch movies at home? Do you borrow them, rent DVDs, or use some cool subscription? I have subscriptions to lots of magazines, mostly fashion ones. What sort of magazines do you read? I love fashion magazines. Do you buy magazines one by one or have subscriptions to them? I have subscriptions to them, mostly in my mother's name. She gets special discount deals as she's an interior designer. I get Vogue, T, Teen Vogue, Marie Claire, Elle, Bazaar, Town and Country, InStyle, Lucky, and EW. Plus Wired. I know it's a lot. How many magazines do you get each month? You should. Which are your favorite magazines? My favorite magazine is Vogue. Anna Wintour is good at discovering new designers and I adore Hamish Bowles' writing and Grace Coddington's fashion scenarios. Do you read magazines on an iPad or other tablet device? Am I boring you? Care to give me a gift? I suppose so. Quick question, celebrity chit chat, yay or nay? Going to Paris is my big dream. Do you like traveling? It's great, isn't it? I'm curious about so many places. Have you ever been abroad? Where have you been so far? I've visited some famous travel destinations around the US, seen a little bit of Europe and Japan, and been to Jamaica recently. Do you like traveling? I think everyone likes it. Traveling is all about new things. I like trying new stuff. What do you like best, big cities or little towns? Me too. I love city life, the commotion, the action is energizing. The mix of people, food and fun impresses me. If you could go anywhere in the world, where would you go? I've got a year off and I want to travel. I'm just planning my next trip. I'd love to go to Fashion Week. New York, London, Milan, Paris, at least one of them. Which one would you choose? New York rules, but when it comes to Fashion Week, I'd rather go to Europe because their designs are more unique. I've been there briefly when I was very small. I went to France. Can't remember anything about it. You're right. I'm absolutely in love with everything about France. Telling me not to do something usually has the opposite effect. Where would you go for a romantic getaway? I wanna go to Paris so bad. Paris is a must for every fashion-conscious traveler. Do you know that shopping in Paris is something of an art? Gosh, I could talk about Paris and fashion for hours. Fine. I always like to experience a city the way the locals do. Do you read travel guides? Do you rely strictly on them? I usually check travel guides, but I find it more fun to learn from locals. When in Paris, do as the Parisians do. What would your perfect romantic day look like? My perfect romantic day in Paris would start with coffee in one of the legendary cafes, followed by shopping and a boat trip on the Seine. I'm glad it's clear to you. Who do you travel with? It takes some guts to go alone. Were you ever in danger? I've mostly traveled with my parents so far, and our high school class went on a couple of trips. Do you like school trips? Which one was your worst? I loved school trips. They were so funny and crazy. Thinking is good. 1. The movie Gravity won 7 Oscars. What is gravity? A. Am I boring you? How about making some wind? I suppose so. I have a cute story from the karaoke bar. Wanna hear? Cool. Tom and me went to a karaoke bar. Tom chose "You're the One That I Want" from the movie Grease. In the middle of the song, he started dancing wildly. He didn't notice a spilled drink on the floor. He slipped and fell on his back. When he fell, he screamed "Woo-hoo-hoo" in time with the song's chorus. Everybody clapped. It was the most hilarious and the cutest thing I've ever seen him do. Ooh, I have an idea. You're gonna love it. Beats me. Let's talk about you for a change. I have some fun questions. Ready? Great. Would you rather A. fly planes, B. ride trains? Yup. If you want to understand birds, you've got to see things from their perspective. A backpack or a handbag? Being practical is the most important, but style does come in different forms. Would you rather build A stone house, B a wooden house? Aren't you a smart little piggy? Did you know you can't lick your elbow? Do you think storms are A. cool, B. scary? Great. Don't make me angry and save yourself from a storm or two. Would you rather spend your day A. surfing the internet, B. surfing the ocean? Look into my eyes. Swoosh, swa, broom. Surf's up. Would you rather A. wash and hang clothes, B. do the dishes? Oh, whatever. Why am I even mentioning the chores? Duh. Would you rather A. walk barefoot, B. wear shoes that are 2 sizes too small for you? Just one piece of advice, avoid the dog poop. I'm typically quite busy every day. What have you done today? But you just came here. Let's chat some more. Bye then. See you soon. Hey, I saved you a chair and everything. Okay. I could do with some music here. Are you into music? I don't like it when you make me angry. Let's just forget about it, shall we? How about remembering the best days of your life? Yup, school. Wanna talk about school? Oh, but you'd feel better if we talked about it? Tell me all about it. I recently finished high school. It feels great to be free. Are you in high school? I'm taking a year off now. High school was a busy time. Homework, studying, hanging out with friends. Did you like your school? I liked my time at high school. Especially the theater after school and all the time spent with my friends. However, the best thing about school was the prom. Fine. We won't talk about prom. Hey, I've been busy with something PAWSOME. It's my biggest project ever. I've got a brand new app. Guess what it's called? A. Talking Angela 3. B. My Talking Angela. C. Your Talking Angela. It's like My Talking Tom. Only much better. Guess what you can do in my new app? A. Trade stickers with friends. B. Customize and upgrade my home. C. Try out the latest fashions. Right. Do you know where I live in my new app? A. New York. B. Under the sea. C. In tropics. All of them are correct. You can change the location of my home by changing the view from my terrace. Final question, which of these potions is not in the app? A. Hungry potion. B. Baby potion. C. Disappear potion. Kittens are cute and cuddly. It's good to have one when you need it. Yay, let's play my Talking Angela app now. Help me grow from a baby kitten to a stylish cat. I don't know. Sometimes I put on my sunglasses and pretend nobody knows who I am. Love sunglasses? Want to chat about it? Great, we can wear shades. I love wearing sunglasses, they make me feel famous. Which is a bit mad cause those people wear them to remain discreet. Famous people don't want the paparazzi spotting them. Have you ever tried to hide by wearing sunglasses? Did it work? Cool, you escaped the paparazzi. I don't know what that is. I don't usually try to hide myself. Only pretend I am doing so. Sunglasses do disguise who you are. It's weird that it works. How would I know? Like in photos with a black strip across the eyes, you can't easily identify someone if you can't see their eyes. Tom is a big star, and he knows it. Your name is Tom. Let's talk about celebs. On a scale from 1 to 10, how much do you gossip? Care to give me a gift? It's great. Almost everyone is keen on sports. How about you? I think this is a pretty scenic neighborhood. I love taking photos. Do you? Sometimes it gets too quiet round here. I usually keep my reader in my purse. Are you into books? Not a bookworm then. The best cure for boredom is to get active. I've taken up skateboarding, have you tried it? It does take a lot of balance and practice. I think some sort of exercise is a good thing. I don't want to turn into a fat cat. Do you ever worry about diet and exercise? Which one? You have this Zen attitude of no worries. Did I just hear my cell ring? No, must have been yours. I'm so addicted to my phone. Are you the same? Okay. I carry my cell phone everywhere I go. I wish I had a pouch so I'd always have somewhere to put it. Do you use a cell phone regularly? Just for calls and texting then? Indeed. My parents pay my phone bill, but they warn me not to overdo the calls and internet use. Cool. They set limits, but I go over every month. If I do it again, they'll take it out of my allowance. Less money for clothes shopping. Have you tried to look for the good in it? Do you pay your own phone bill? Are there limits set on you? I wish I had a car. So, I changed my mind. I use my phone to stay connected to my friends. Are you the same? Always texting and tweeting and posting photos on FB? It's a wonder you even enjoy talking to me. YouTube and Hulu are very popular. Right. Perhaps you find TV stars the ones to watch. I used to watch a lot of TV, these days not so much. Are you a couch potato with square eyes? But perhaps you'd still like to chat about TV? Okay, I'll believe you're one of the few who don't care about TV. I didn't know that. One pleasure that goes with watching TV is eating ice cream. Curling up on a pile of cushions with a dish of creamy goodness is wonderful. Are you one of those who use ice cream as comfort food? Yes, let's go pick out verbally at least. I think the worst thing about living in the Stone Age would be having no ice cream. Refrigeration is so cool. Do you like ice cream? It is the ultimate pleasure of civilization. Which do you think is better, ice cream or milkshake? Such a great drink. Which is your favorite ice cream flavor? I am always torn between chocolate and vanilla. Vanilla is so full of creamy goodness, but chocolate is so rich and chocolatey. I usually have a double cone with both flavors. I know, I'll be a fat cat one day. I am tall and slim. How do you expect me to become such? Cool. I'll bet you want to chat about milky goodness, rich creamy butter and impossibly delicious cream, don't you? Let's go get creamy together. Perhaps you're hungry for me to tell you a story? I love reading magazines, I probably see too many. Are you into colorful diversions like this? Not even into serious journals? No, don't tell me, I'd be bored. Okay. A big time sink for some people is playing video games. Are you guilty of that? Beep beep ping splat. These days video games are out for me. I play apps on my iPhone or iPad. I love to design and accessorize my outfits. I customize them with some neat tricks like tying decorative knots. Yes, it is. Do you end up filling every moment of your day? My grandpa says everyone should have a useful hobby rather than lazy precious time away. But grandpa forgets to use the word fun. Useful without having fun spoils the hobby's true purpose. Yup. I have many hobbies, but I like to tease Grandpa that I'm getting proficient in lazing and call that a hobby. Want to hear his reply? One of my hobbies is designing hats. Yesterday, I saw a really amazing fascinator. Do you know what a fascinator is? It's a hat perching at dangerous angle. It's called a fascinator, presumably as people watch fascinated in case it falls off. Do you want to hear more about the fascinator I saw yesterday? I got the idea for this hat in a designer's shop window, but I'll make it even more dramatic. It's a little cocktail hat that perches on this side of my head, and I'm going to make a slit for my ear. Indeed. Usually I use an Alice band with Velcro to keep it from falling off, but now the ear slit will do the trick. Fine. I'll put it on my Facebook when it's done. Wait, I just got another idea. What about what? There's no reason to have a hat just on the head. I'll add a face mask as a fascinator extension. What do you think? It could be a tiny feathered thing around my eyes. So now you know about my hat design. It's mostly too expensive for me to buy designer things, so I make my own. Or I buy a cheaper piece and customize it. I thank you. How nice. I don't know. Do you ever sketch anything you'd love to wear? That's cool. Do you also make it and actually wear it? How do you make your sketches? I like to use my touchpad for design sketching. Tablets must have been designed for cats, really. I can sing you a song.
You get me, and I get you. Together, there's really nothing we can.
I'll just have to go ask someone else. And I thought you were nice. And I thought you were nice. I don't want to hear about that anymore. Done with. I'm bored with quarreling. Don't think I'm always lazy. When I was at high school, I had several summer jobs. My, did your mother teach you that? Let's forget about all that. You insult me. Blah blah, whatever. Of course I'm angry. Because your sexual talk is insulting. I didn't like that. Why do you want to upset me like that? It's over with. Go hug a cactus. Go hug a tiger. You've really upset me. Is there an echo in your head while you speak? It's over with. Okay, hating this. I've already forgotten about it. Mind your language. Forget about it. You should find a soulmate for that kind of conversation. Have you tried a rock? The English police issue ASPO orders for people like you. Let it be. go pet a crocodile. Why are you being so nasty to me? Go hug a cactus. I would suggest you go to the South Pole, but you would just get over with. Why are you insulting me? No problemo. It wasn't that bad. But we have a cat's pajamas time together. Could you stay? Does that mean you'll stay? Okay, bye. I had a great time with you.